Of that geek news. And I know for many, today is a very special day, but above all else, I pray, I hope, and wish you and yours well, a safe holiday, and just a safe remainder of the year in general. But because many of us can't be with our loved ones, friends, and family, and because many of us can't be with our loved ones, friends, and family, I decided that maybe to brighten up the spirits, how about we shift gears just a little bit and talk about some of those Black Friday sales. I know you've been thirsty. Many companies, because of the global miasma, have already started to not only prepare for Black Friday at the beginning of the month, but many of their rollout sales are already active, such as the Nintendo Switch version, such as the Nintendo Switch bundle, such as the Mario Kart 8 Nintendo Switch bundle at Best Buy and on Amazon for $2.99.
With a bundle that cheap, we must be getting prepared for Mario Kart 9.
So if you think that you are going to be able to snatch up a Nintendo Switch because you weren't able to get a PS5 or Xbox One, hold it. Pump your brakes, that player. Pump your brakes. That's going to also be a hard commodity to get because a Nintendo Switch has already been having its own special deals before Black Friday, and I'm pretty sure the Nintendo Switch is going to be just as hard to find as a PlayStation 5 or Xbox Series X. Some of the Black Friday sales for the Nintendo Switch are a 128GB SanDisk for $19.99. Yes, still the price of the terabytes haven't dropped, but for 20 bucks, that's pretty much some fast food now. You can get an extra 128GB, which ain't too bad. Also on Amazon, The Legend of Zelda Link's Awakening is $39.99. Luigi's Mansion will also be $39.99. And Super Mario Maker 2 will be $30.99 as well. If you already haven't picked up Splatoon 2 like me, well, it's going to be on Amazon for $34.99 with Super Mario Bros. 2 the Deluxe and Fire Emblem 3 Houses, my favorite Nintendo Switch game, for $39.99. Super Smash Bros. Ultimate is still at a top tier price, only taking $10 off, coming in at $49.99. And The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild is going to be $44.99, as well as Mario Kart 8 Deluxe and Super Mario Party. Both are coming in $44.99. The Witcher 3 will be $39.99. Minecraft Dungeons $19.99. Mortal Kombat 11 The Aftermath is coming in at $24.99. Yoshi's Crafted the Digital is going to be $39.99. And Mario Tennis Aces will be $34.99. NBA 2K1 will be $27.99, and the Need for Speed Remastered coming in at $24.99 as well. Not to be outdone, Walmart has a standard $30 for the Luigi Mansion, Link's Awakening, Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu, the new Mario Bros. U Deluxe, Pokemon Let's Go Eevee, Splatoon 2, Yoshi's Crafted World, Mario Tennis Aces, Super Mario Maker 2, and Fire Emblem 3 Houses. If y'all need to get that if you ain't got it already. GameStop has pretty much around the same prices, and it's too many for me to list right here. But the PlayStation 4, Amazon has Cyberpunk 2077, which ain't even out yet, at $49.99. Marvel Spider-Man for $19.99. Ghost of Tsushima for $39.99. The Last of Us Part 2 for $29.99, as well as Madden 21 for $26.99. God of War is going to be $9.99. The original Last of Us will be $9.99 as well. And Marvel's VR Iron Man will be $19.99. NBA 2K21 at $27.99. The Avengers at $29.99. FIFA at $26.99. And Assassin's Creed Valhalla at $49.99. Crash 4 It's About Time will be $39.99. Dragon Ball Z Kakarot, which is a really underrated game, will be coming in at $14.99. Yakuza Like a Dragon will be $49.99. Borderlands 3 Super Deluxe Edition will be $29.99. And Street Fighter V The Champions Edition will be $19.99. Some of the great PS4 Best Buy deals will be Far Cry 5 for $12.99, Far Cry New Dawn for $14.99, Assassin's Creed Odyssey for $14.99, Final Fantasy VII The Remake, The Remastered, The Reimagining at a very cost-affordable $29.99. Ghost of Tsushima will be $39.99, The Last of Us 2 will be $29.99, along with The Avengers will be $29.99. Doom Eternal is coming in at $19.99, and Dragon Ball FighterZ for $12.99. Kingdom Hearts 3, oh, I think I might need to pick that up, will be $9.99, and Jump Force for $12.99. MLB The Show 20 will be $9.99. Nier Automata, the Game of the Year version, will be $12.99. And the Uncharted Nathan Drake Collection will be $9.99. Yakuza, the Remastered Collection, is coming in at $24.99. And Batman Arkham VR will be $9.99. Some of the top Walmart PS4 pickups for Black Friday will be $25 for Red Redemption 2, $25 for Star Wars Squadron, Crash Team Racing Nitro Fuel for $20, Trials of Mana will be $20, Grand Theft Auto 5, the Premium Edition, will be $15, Horizon Zero Dawn, the Complete Edition, will also be $15, and Tekken 7 will be coming in at $15 as well. And for the Xbox One, Amazon has Cyberpunk 2077 at $49.99. Like a Dragon at $49.99. Watch Dogs Legion at $29.99. Halo, the Master Chief Collection at $29.99. Star Wars Squadron for $16.99. NBA 2K21 at $27.99. UFC 4 for $35.99. And FIFA 21 at $35.99. Minecraft Dungeons Hero Editions at $14.99. Ori, The Will of the Wisps for $14.99, The Sims for The Sims 4 for $19.99, Assassin's Creed Valhalla for $49.99, and Star Wars Battlefront for $9.99, and Resident Evil 2 at $14.99. Best Buy has some pretty solid Xbox pickups as well. Assassin's Creed Odyssey at $14.99, Bayonetta the 10th Anniversary Bundle for $29.99, Crash Bandicoot 4 for $49.99, Cuphead, a digital copy, for $14.99, Doom Eternal at $19.99, Dragon Ball FighterZ at $12.99, Dragon Ball Z Kakarot at $14.99, Far Cry 5 at $12.99, Halo 5 at $9.99, Halo Wars 2 at $9.99, Hellblade Senua's Sacrifice at $9.99, Hitman 2 at $14.99, Jump Force at $12.99, NBA 2K21 at $27.99, NASCAR Heat 5 at $29.99, Ori the Will of the Wisp, and the Collector's Edition for the same game at $29.99. Resident Evil 2 and Resident Evil 3 both come in at $14.99 a piece, and Resident Evil 7 the Gold Edition is at $12.99. Watchdog Legion $29.99 and The Witcher 3 Complete at $19.99. GameStop comes in with Kingdom Hearts 3 at $9.99, Code Vein, which I really still need to pick up, at $9.99, The Sims, The Journey, Star Wars Journey to the Batuu Bundle at $19.99, Monster Energy Supercross, the official video game 3 at $19.99, Fallout 4, the Game of the Year Edition at $19.99, Walmart will be having The Avengers at $30, Tony Hawk's Pro Skater 1 Plus 2, as well as UFC 4 for $30 a piece. Final Fantasy X Plus X2 High Definition version for $30. Final Fantasy 12 The Zodiac Age for $30. Seems a little pricey. NBA 2K21 for $28. Madden NFL 21 for $28. Halo 5 for $15. Ori and the Wisps Digital, $15. Bleeding Edge also comes in at $15, as well as Destroy All Humans and Halo Wars 2 and Tom Clancy's Rainbow Six Siege, all at $15 a piece. And this is just a drop in the bucket of some of the Black Friday sales that will be going live on Wednesday, the 25th. I will put the full link in the description below, and I wish you luck and safety if you're going out there in these streets. If you can, please order from home. But if you must go to get these sales, again, please take care of yourself. And as always, Interweb, this has been your man Q, your friendly neighborhood geek. If you did like this video, do me a favor and hit that like button. And Interweb, let me know in the comment section below, was there a deal or sale or game that you have to have? And if you're new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe to stay up to date on all things geek. And as always, Interweb, remember to eat, sleep, geek, repeat. I'll holler at y'all later. Peace. And if you're still feeling breezy, here's another video for you right here and right here. Air is